Since the age of six, world-renowned psychic Alison Dubois has helped thousands of people to connect with lost loved ones, and she's even used her gift to crack criminal cases.
That's easier said than done. Now she's giving us the chance to get in touch with the other side on her tour around the country, which starts next month. She's back on our show. We love her. Alison, welcome back. Just want to clarify, the people who are just, you know, meeting you for the first time here, you're in contact with spirits all day, every day. It's just like you pick up the phone and they're there.
Is someone talking to you right now?
No.
Apart from us?
I would have to say, if it wasn't a living person, to have somebody that's deceased constantly talking to you. That's not my life. I have boundaries with the living. I have boundaries with the dead as well. So, no, I'm not one of those people that can't really control their gift. I'm very good at it. So when I want to connect, I connect. And when I want to disconnect, I disconnect.
Yeah. In your book, Talk to Me, you discuss how we can all learn to read signs. So can anyone become a psychic?
I think most people are born with an innate ability to know when the phone rings, you know, a person's face pops into your mind and you just kind of know who's calling you at that moment. But then people don't call that psychic because it's uncomfortable for them. But I think most people have that sixth sense or an intuition, or like I bet David, when he meets people, kind of sizes them up and kind of gets a blueprint of who they are immediately.
I'm a real empath.
He's psychotic.
No, I'm a sidekick.
A sidekick. Yeah,
it's a big difference. What about you? Have three daughters? Have any of them inherited the gift?
It's genetic. It runs in families.
So is it passed down through mothers, or it can go either way?
It can go either way. I find on the father's side, though, and amongst males in general, they're not comfortable with their emotional side, their maternal instincts that they don't know that they had, and I feel like they hold back a little bit more. But it runs on both sides of the family, and so, sure.
Can I ask you something? This is really strange. This happened to me the other day. It was around Australia Day, and I was talking to someone privately about John Williamson, who's a singer here.
True Blue.
True Blue, singing Hey True Blue, and because it's a very Australian song. And the next... Well, in the next hour, on my Twitter feed, John Williamson was following me, following me. So I'm talking about him to someone privately, and the next thing, he's following me on Twitter.
He's a psychic.
Hi, John. Hi. But it was really such a strange coincidence.
How linked you can be in that moment.
Why does that happen?
When somebody randomly pops into your mind and you start talking about him, that was you picking up on that he was actually going to follow you for whatever reason he decided to follow you.
He was thinking about
you,
love.
So that's actually kind of a premonition of something to come. And it's very human and very natural, but people aren't comfortable once you start sticking labels on it.
I also believe if you say John Williamson's name three times, he actually turns up to the studio. It's like Beetlejuice.
I'm just hoping that John Williamson is not a serial killer.
He's not. What a relief.
While you're here, would you be able to do a bit of a reading?
Yeah, I mean, if you had any questions, I'm happy to answer. Oh,
yeah, well, I do, because my grandmother died quite a few years ago, and I know that my mother would want to know how she is, whether she's okay. You know, she had a very hard life. She grew up as a farmer's wife. She had 17 children. My mother is one of 17. They lived on a farm. They never had money. So is she happier now?
You know, people ask me this a lot, so I think your question's a really good one because it'll help a lot of other people. But when you die, the versions of heaven that she had were made while she was alive. So when she was getting your mother dressed as a two-year-old or hugging her or celebrating a holiday, those become her versions of heaven. She gets to relive those moments every day for the rest of her existence if she chooses to. At the same time, she can pop in on your mom or you or any other family member and see what you're doing. But she gets to revisit all of those wonderful moments. And so when your mom wants to know what she's doing, they usually revert to an age where their children were small. And I would imagine she'd be taking care of her children and loving them and spending time with them. So don't think of how they died and that it was a hard life, but rather all those beautiful moments that they had that led up to the end.
That's
beautiful.
Hi, Nana.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, look, Alison will be touring around the country throughout February. You can see how great she is.
Thank you for that. Head to her website
for details. Always good to see you. Next time you're going
to
read
you.
Me.
Well, and Ghostbusters is my ringtone, so I really love that you played my intro. It's like you're psychic and you knew that. It's so weird.
We have the gift.
I asked John Williamson what your ringtone was.